you ask them, but they expect from you. Why don't you tell them what you are gonna do? You'll get so lonely. Maybe it's better that way. It ain't you only. You got something to say. Do anything you wanna do. Do anything you wanna do. Gonna break out of this city. Leave the people here behind. Searching for adventure is the type of life you'll find.
Thank you ever so much. It's not often that these songs get recognised.
Indeed, they're very appropriate to the content.
I've started thinking about them rather than just throwing them out there.
Yeah, definitely the last couple of weeks you've certainly put a lot of thought into your song choices.
I thought the last 3 weeks particularly.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah?
Could you wait to see there's a couple of corkers lined up?
Well, for all the news that's about to happen, you mean? You are a time traveller, aren't you?
Yeah,
so that song was obviously in reference to the fact that we, the British people, well, the English people, are now free to do whatever we want, i.e. go to the pub.
Roam the land.
We can go to the pub. Like we went to the pub a lot on Saturday, if the photos are anything to go by.
there's a number of spikes as well, weren't there?
There was local spikes.
What do we call local spikes? Because you know when coronavirus Spikelets. First came to London?
Yeah.
Would that have been a local spike?
That's very true. Yeah, or do they consider like a borough to be a local spike?
I mean, yeah, I was curious because...
That's true. We just locked down Westminster. Right? Yeah.
But anyone can travel around it.
Yeah.
And all the pubs around it will be open. But I don't think the pubs ever closed in Nottinghamshire and Leicestershire.
Perhaps not. Sneaky lock-ins or whatever they are.
Leicestershire, that's where the spike...
Yes.
I like the use of the word spike there as well.
Yeah.
Spike.
Yeah. Flood. They are still in lockdown. They have at least another week of lockdown to go.
At least,
yeah.
Listen and weep, yeah. Leicester. Listen and weep to the voice of freedom.
I wouldn't even mind, but it's all happened this week. Like, so we just literally had an announcement only minutes ago saying that theatres and outside music venues can start to reopen on Saturday.
Outside music venues?
Well, outside music venues and outside theatres, yeah.
So would we say something like, sorry, out the corner of my eye, I can't help but notice you're hiding a guest.
Yes!
It's corner of my eye. I saw somebody there.
He snuck in.
Oh! How are you, Dr. Tench? It's lovely to see you. Sorry.
No, like Mr. Kiff, don't be so formal. It's Nobby. It's Nobby.
Nobby.
Yeah, but Nobby by name, but not by nature.
It's lovely
it's
to,
nice
see
to see
you
again.
I can barely
nice
see you.
It's lovely to have you back.
All right, no problem. I'll be bringing some interesting facts today based on topical So let's.
I look forward to that.
Yeah, we can't so. Wait.
Now, Nobby, did you go out on Saturday?
Not really. One doesn't find one needs to partake of alcohol.
Not in a public setting, no. Anyway. Unlike you, Kivi.
I didn't pop into a pub until Saturday night.
I see.
When I had to meet somebody.
Right. And then you just spent the next 3 days in there.
<Didn't leave. laughs> No, they closed early on Saturday night. They closed at 10:30.
I see.
In Acton. Mm-hmm. I went to Acton to meet somebody. Two people, actually. And none of us were in the same household.
Oh.
We were being a bit risque.
And you were inside? Naughty, naughty.
Well, we were in the garden.
Oh, I see.
But it was a covered area. That's why I was able to have a cigar.
Oh, I see.
I didn't want a cigar. I had a really sore throat for 2 days. Oh, 3 days.
Well, you know, self-inflicted. I have very little sympathy.
So, but I was going back to the outdoor venues.
Was the sore throat before the cigar?
Yeah. The real question. But,
you heard it here first. But the outdoor venues.
Yes, what about them?
Do the people still have to be 2 metres apart?
I would assume so, to be perfectly honest with you. I would, or at least a metre, because, you know, we can go down to a metre now to help the economy.
But given the weather we're having,
we might have to be
the last
masked,
week
though.
Where it hasn't stopped raining.
Yes, that's very true.
I mean, it was a plague, flood.
Yeah, locusts. Also, I wouldn't mind, but they've said that outdoor venues can open from Saturday. Do you think all the theatre troupes and the bands are suddenly frantically trying to like develop a lineup and a performance?
Now, I haven't played for 3 months.
Yeah.
But I did notice, just going back to that, flood, pestilence, whatever.
Famine.
There is a huge wave of locusts coming through Africa.
That's right,
as we speak. There's something in there.
And murder hornets, wasn't it, in America?
Yep.
Although I think they've
murder
gone for
hornets.
Some reason. I don't, or they never really...
They've been replaced by the police.
Yeah. I like it. Well done.
Could I just, before we move that subject, could I just clear up one thing with Miss Fork? You said a plague of locusts. Now, is that locusts or locusts?
Deadly locusts.
Oh, thank you, Miss Fork.
When it comes to that kind of thing.
Hold on, what's the other?
We were just having a science-y talk before we came on air, and she mentioned a gene locus. I was astounded.
A gene
locus.
Locus.
She really meant locus.
No, I meant locus.
Oh.
Yeah. Locus is an insect.
Right. Nice to see that the sabers are out.
Yeah. We'll have to continue this off the air.
we'll continue that off air.
Maybe a wrestling ring.
So in other announcements today about coronavirus, outdoor sports will be allowed from the 25th of July.
Oh, hold on.
I was watching the cricket, you know, how many minutes of it before rain stopped play.
Football going on at the moment, isn't there?
And there is football going on
even
at the moment.
Even as we speak, Leeds are playing Stoke.
Gyms and swimming pools will be open.
Of course, because coronavirus is so far out of the system. Well,
coronavirus doesn't like water, so it's all fine.
No, that's right. It
or chlorine, perhaps, as well.
But in the gym, as you're huffing and puffing as you go for your...
Yeah, as you're slicking your sweat all over the mats.
How will they control that? I'm intrigued.
Yeah, I really don't know. They said they're going to have deep cleans, but they will need to be... Like, you'll almost have
constant.
To assign a cleaner to a customer and just have them clean everything after
wiping your brow.
Yeah.
Change it, a quick change of shirt.
Spraying disinfectant at you.
You don't have that already. In my gym, we do have that.
Fancy gym.
I see. Actually, there is one. I know of a chap that he left our local gym that we both used to use, the council one.
Okay.
And he went to one in North London, and I have to say that I was astounded. You get tea and biscuits when you go in there.
Oh, right, okay.
They say coffee, decaf.
Did it
regular.
Have a sort of a sciencey name, this place?
It did.
Yes. I may have frequented that place. It's rather posh. But, but yeah. It's this how you interact.
It seems interesting to be offering tea and biscuits at a gym.
If you're going to exercise, you need some cake afterwards.
Yeah, I guess.
And you get a choice of vegan.
Oh, very
fancy. Dairy free.
Okay.
Yeah. Mine used to just be chocolate or Lucozade.
Yeah.
I used to run out of water all the time.
I can kind of understand, but yeah, cake is a new one on me.
But it's ironic that diabetics probably need more exercise, rather.
Possibly.
So giving them Lucozade is not really going to help them, is it? You can call me old-fashioned on this one.
It just cancels it out. Speaking of cake, Rishi, and this is Rishi Sunak to you, is giving us all vouchers.
First name terms with him.
Yeah. Oh, Rishi Dishy. Dishy Rishi.
I thought you were going to refer to me as a beefcake.
Rish the dish.
Rish the dish. Of cake.
He's a national treasure at the moment. He's saving the British public. He's giving everyone vouchers for the month of August. So this is for us to be able to eat out to help out. Which is the new slogan of the British government.
Is this between Mondays and Wednesdays?
Yeah. Mondays, Tuesdays and Wednesdays only.
Because it reminds me that all those people that have been furloughed and have 20% less of their wages and some even more have got the money to spend on going out on Mondays to Wednesdays, haven't they? Good old Rishi.
Yeah, perhaps, yeah. I mean, it's 50% off your meal, including drinks, but not alcohol.
Yeah, but a meal you wouldn't normally go out for because you're so poor you can't afford to buy food.
Possibly. Mm. It depends also what restaurants sign up for it, because if it's going to be places like the Ivy and, you know, places like that, then we're not really going to go for it, are we?
I don't know.
When the rest of your meal is going to be 50 quid.
I think a little bit more than that.
I will say, apparently it's only two... So it's a maximum of 10 quid per person. As long as your meal as a whole isn't over a ten, isn't over 20 quid, you've made the 50%.
You haven't made. You spent 10 pounds you would normally spend on a feel-good feel that will last. It won't even last all of August. You won't be able to pay your rent or your electricity.
But you're helping
out in style.
But you're helping the economy.
Aren't you just good old, what's his name, Rishi.
Rishi.
I bet it's Richie, isn't it? He just wants to pronounce it.
Maybe,
With Colin and all those other American names.
He's pledged $30 billion into what he calls the coronavirus budget, or what has been dubbed the coronavirus
budget.
So
he's given $30 billion and he expects
out of his own
us
pocket,
to give $30 billion as well.
Yeah, exactly.
I love conservative politics. The economy is going to thrive under this lot, isn't it? Fantastic.
I love it. Especially after a load of people working in Boots and John Lewis have lost their
just
jobs
lost their
today.
Jobs. Yeah. They're probably sitting there rubbing
amongst,
their hands.
Amongst multiple other companies this week. However, if you're buying a house, now is a good time to do it because the stamp duty has been, they've taken a holiday is what they've referred to it as until next March.
Up to £500,000.
Up to £500,000,
so if anyone's been furloughed, lost their job, they've actually been made redundant, now's the time to buy that £499,000 house.
And that house you always wanted is well within reach now.
Take all your mates out for a meal. As well, with the money you've got left over.
A celebratory meal after you buy a house. Although a lot of people are angry, though, because this literally came in yesterday. So for all of those who completed their house purchases on Monday and Tuesday, unfortunately are still liable for those, you know, £10,000 or whatever
no
it is.
There's pleasing some people, is there?
No, there isn't.
Golly jeepers.
Oh, yes.
Could you buy a house in London for that much?
Well, if it was the size of a shed on the outskirts of London,
so it's really for the.
You might be able to buy an apartment for that size.
Well, the great thing is, of course, next year you've got along with the extra charges and everything losing their jobs and whatnot, you've got the extra charge for the ULEZ coming right out to the North Circular.
Just to help
us out even more. Good old Sadiq and the Conservatives working hand in
parking
hand.
Parking is good. You're going to have to pay more in parking, presumably, or permits to.
And I've got my old car that belches out more dirt than Battersea
Power
Station did.
Which, for some reason, isn't included in the ULEZ.
Right, it's not,
requirements.
No.
It doesn't
I
make any
drive
sense.
I anywhere
to me.
I like in that.
In other coronavirus news, Mission Impossible 7. Allowed to start filming again.
Another one.
And apparently he's got two in the works. He's full of ideas, is Tom Cruise.
It's a shame he wasn't as tall as he is for ideas. He'd be huge. 8'4".
He probably would. He's been in Oxfordshire this week.
Oh, there was an outbreak of coronavirus there.
Was there? Interesting.
There's loads of Americans over at the moment.
Yeah, I know, because obviously they don't want to be in America. Worse.
Yeah, in America, you don't want to be there.
We've offered them sanctuary.
They can't go back to America.
We've offered them asylum.
From the asylum.
Hong Kong was going to hate them for that.
Yeah. Another the Americans reason. Got in there first. As well as that, Oliver Dowden has also pledged money to save the theatres.
Who's that? Sorry, remind me of his name again.
This is Oliver Dowden, isn't it? Is that how you say his name?
Yeah.
Who is Oliver Dowden?
He's the culture secretary.
Yeah. The culture secretary.
Yeah.
The director of business, did he die or
oh,
did
we yeah,
never
we never heard,
heard him again?
From him again, did we?
No.
Well, isn't it something shawarma or something like that? Isn't
Not
it?
Anymore, no, that's Kier. He's your position. The chap, whatever his name was, he suddenly had this coronavirus.
That's right, yeah, he tested positive and he's never seen again.
It'd be interesting to say, because he was a BAME member.
Yes, he
and
is.
And they were pointing out that BAME members were the ones that were getting it because of their socioeconomic problems.
Very true.
I'm not sure he
had any socioeconomic problems.
Very
to
big
be honest.
House, very big, big amount of big wages.
Probably.
And a huge private care plan.
I suspect so.
Be interested to see what they get out of this one.
Oh, dear. Speaking of, who else has tested positive for coronavirus is Brazil's president.
Bolsonaro.
Bolsonaro, yes.
That sounds like a dance, doesn't
he
it?
He is taking, on Trump's recommendation, he is taking the malaria drug.
And what's that stuff, the stuff that really clean him out?
Acid, yeah.
What, you mean... yeah. You mean cleaning reagent.
Oh, right.
So according to himself, he is fine. Although everyone is, obviously concerned. He's an old man in Brazil. They're not.
But he's fine.
Well.
I trust his word.
You trust his word?
Given that he did point out that it was just made up, wasn't it?
Yeah. It's a bit of a cough and a bit of a sniffle.
Just a little flu.
Until they went, soaring into first place above us all.
Yeah. I still think they're there.
America have got 60,000 deaths
recorded. They're doing very well, actually.
Not deaths, sorry, recorded 6,000 new cases.
And speaking of, Florida in particular is definitely winning that race at the moment.
Oh,
is
it raging on?
Is it taken over from Texas?
I think it has. I think it has this week anyway.
Florida.
Although, Disneyland Florida are reopening on Saturday. So get your tickets here.
I'd love to see. You know, they give away those prizes, like two tickets to Disneyland. Who's going to want those now?
Well,
they'll probably move
Americans,
down to second place.
I suppose. Yeah, so we shall see how everyone gets on at Disneyland.
Imagine that, though. I mean, what does Donald Trump think is going to happen? He's just going to... Everyone's going to get this herd immunity.
I'm not even sure if he's even twigged that there is such thing as herd immunity.
I know he knows
it's
Disneyland.
Or does he just think, oh, I couldn't be bothered anymore? I did read at one point that they were still... You know, like that the American government were basically going to take that stance of deal with it. As opposed to,
don't you just
trying
love
to actually
the
do
way
anything.
They do things over there?
Yes.
They've got private health... plans everywhere, haven't they? They've got a really good health system if you can afford it.
If you can afford it,
so that's what Trump's trying to do is get rid of all the poor people.
If you already haven't lost your job in the in the crisis that they had in April,
they want
and
their
May.
Train drivers wearing suits, don't
yeah,
they?
Yeah. Apparently, it costs something like $200 to get the COVID test to see whether you're positive or not. So.
Wow.
Despite the fact that they have something ridiculous like 100,000 positive cases a day, that's probably triple that number yeah. of people who just can't or will not pay for that COVID test.
Choice. Food or the test?
Yeah, food for a month or the test. And we still expect you in work on Monday, you know. I'm looking at Worldometer here because obviously we love a bit of Worldometer on this show. And the USA is currently in first place.
Oh, USA, USA.
Yep, with over 3 million cases.
Now, how are they in terms of, where are Brazil?
Brazil are second. With 1,700,000
Wow,
cases.
So they've got some catching up to do, which I'm
they
very
actually do,
I'm
yeah,
confident
yeah,
that
America's
they will
taken
get
it
there.
By storm.
They will get there. It's a bit like the gold medal table at the Death Olympics, isn't it?
Yep.
But what about the deaths, though? Who's number one with the deaths?
Well, let's have a look. Total deaths is still the USA. They are currently
USA,
on 135,000 people.
I have friends in the USA and I worry about them because it's just mental. And I think, if that had happened here, I think, what would have happened? Would there have been riots? Oh, there were, weren't there?
Yeah. Lord. Huh? I will actually also say, so the Americans came out this week again, and what they've decided to do is, because most universities in America are moving to online courses, as most universities are across the world, actually, they've decided that they're not giving visas to international students. So,
but didn't Harvard and MIT try to sue Trump for that?
They did, yeah. Yes. And there are some universities that are trying to loophole themselves around it, but I'm not sure how successful they have been.
Well, it depends how much they pay their lawyers. If they pay
probably,
those, those backstreet ones that say specialising in this, you see them all over the place here, don't
yeah,
you?
Very true, very true.
No win, no fee. But the ones with the big corporate lawyers, they'll get them. Yale, Harvard.
Yeah,
Harvard,
yeah. And Berkeley Stanford. As well, I think, was one of the ones that was trying to find a loophole. So,
Find one.
They're running out of time. They need to get on that. They've only got until September.
Mind you, will they? They'll probably shunt it along now, won't they? So, you can start your course in October, November.
Maybe.
Given that people don't start until October anyway.
Well, that's kind of true, especially in university.
And then they only go until May. They'll probably say, well, maybe we could encourage you to do a few extra weeks.
If I was a foreign student, though, I wouldn't actually want to go to the USA.
I'd
be well happy with just sitting at home
come,
online.
Who would want to go?
But
it's
you
not,
could get
it's
free
not
tickets.
The uproar that the Americans think it is.
To Disneyland, couldn't you? They could probably try and try some over with those.
Yep, that's very true, actually, yeah.
Because after the first week of Disneyland World being open, there'll be loads of spaces left.
Oh.
You can't stand me now, you can't stand me now, you can't stand me now.
Science Corner, all right.
And that was our new jingle. Introducing
fantastic?
The next segment of the show.
Was that Mariah Carey singing that?
We won't reveal our sources. Mm-hmm. Yes, hello, Dr. Chench.
Oh,
you're back.
Yes, thank
our
you, Siobhan.
Our time of the month has come.
It is. Yeah, every time of this, at this time of the month, I usually come. Right. Right. Before I start, I should say that I've just had a tweet here from, just to remind you, it's Nobby Knows to One.
Oh,
sorry.
Yeah, Nobby Knows One.
Yeah, at Nobby Knows One. So it's a Mrs. Fencing's from East Kilbride.
Good old Mrs.
Fencing.
Yes.
She loves it.
Now, she's suffering in the lockdown.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you know that she keeps chickens, don't you? And she's got all these eggs. She's sick of eggs.
Okay.
So she said... No, Dr. Tench, can you tell us what I can do with these eggs? I'm sick of boiled, scrambled, etc. So, I've got one of Tench's tips here.
Well, fantastic. Go on, yeah. Give it to us, Nobby.
Right, okay. You know, if you add some butter,
okay,
chocolate, sugar, flour, then bake, yes, it's not so boring. You can eat them every day. Just mix it up.
Hold on, isn't there a time of year you're meant to do those?
So that's how you can use eggs. and they won't be so boring, yeah? As a tip from Tench. So, Siobhan, you were going to tell me about some things in the news because there were some sciencey bits you wanted explaining.
Yes. I am very concerned this week reading about the private life, the very much private life of Johnny Depp and Amber Heard. So we all know that they've been
in court.
And
it's not quite so private anymore.
It's not private anymore, no. And funnily enough, I feel almost a bit like a voyeur, you know, like reading about the things that are going on.
It's like being in that red light district Amsterdam where you put coins in for it to go up and down.
One of the things that particularly distressed me, which was splayed all over the papers on Wednesday, was Johnny Depp... admitting, I suppose is the word to use, that he decided it was time to divorce Amber after she defecated in their bed.
Right.
And I just want to know, Dr. Tench.
Splayed all over the paper, was it?
Dr. Tench, I just want to know, like, does Amber have a problem?
Oh, yeah. Yes. Well, it's. I saw those. I read those with dismay, I have to say.
I think we all did.
Yeah. Plastered all over the front pages.
When you say that you have a problem, you mean mentally or...
Well, Dr. Tench, particularly I'm asking about a physical problem.
Well,
but, I mean, we all know that she's got some mental
problems. This could be a bit of education for us all, actually. No, so when you look at the signs and symptoms of these, so, you know, because sometimes it's called bowel incontinence or fecal incontinence. And it can be upsetting and embarrassing. So, you know.
Fair enough.
If any listeners, you know, that have this problem.
Amber, if you're listening.
Ask yourself these questions. You have a problem if you have sudden urges to poo that you can't control. You saw yourself without realizing and you needed the toilet. You sometimes leak poo, for example, when you pass wind.
Leak poo. Oh, God.
It happens every day from time to time, a one-off incident when you're ill.
Hold on. No, it doesn't happen to everyone, though, does it?
No, but if it's happening to you every day.
Right, yeah, okay.
And is it affecting your daily life and stopping you socialising?
You'd like to think.
Or sleeping.
Well, then you probably have some fecal incontinence. So you're probably aware of, you know, the bladder incontinence, but fecal incontinence, they can treat them. You can wear pads. Or small plugs you put in your bottom.
Oh, Kip, you're a fan of those, aren't you?
But for different reasons, that's very different
reasons. You can have changes to your diet, such as avoiding foods that make diarrhea worse. Yeah. Medicine to reduce constipation or diarrhea.
Well, okay. I don't even want to reduce constipation.
And
in this
one thing
reasons.
Which I think we could all do now, really, is exercise is to strengthen the muscles that control your bowel.
Interesting.
They're sort of pelvic floor exercises.
Okay.
So we can do some of those.
I'm doing them right now.
Yeah. Miss Fork is doing that. So if you look at Miss Fork,
and I mean,
there.
She should really do it with her trousers on. Yeah. Come on.
Yes. Right. So, so it could be that Amber has this problem.
It could be,
or it could have been the drugs and the alcohol that caused it.
It could also have been. I actually feel disappointed that it wasn't really explained how it came to be that Johnny Depp woke up to shit in his bed.
Yeah. She said it was for a laugh.
She did come out and say it was a prank. Yes. But I still don't feel like that gives us the whole story.
But judging by some of the signs and symptoms, it probably followed a laugh. So if you look at the risk factors.
Risk factors, yep.
Yeah. Age. Now,
age.
So if you're over 65.
She's 34, I think.
Yeah, so
she is 34.
I don't
but
think
you can
the
always
age
be an exception
thing
to the
comes
rule.
Into it with her. So you have to be
over
65.
Actually, maybe a bit immature, because I know the fecal pranks happen both sides of your teens. As it were.
Yeah.
Well, you know, when you're a child, well, you're a small baby in nappies.
I don't know.
That's not a prank, though, is it?
I still, yeah, no.
You haven't known the children, I have.
You're not doing it for a laugh.
Yeah. You are, Dad. Right. Another risk factor, excuse present company accepted, is being female.
Oh!
Yeah. So she does tick that box.
Interesting. Yeah.
Only for us.
I wonder why that is.
The reason why is not all female, because it's a fecal incontinence can be a complication of childbirth.
Ah.
Recent research has found that women who take menopausal hormone replacement therapy are more likely to have fecal incontinence.
Oh, Jesus. Yeah. It all gets so fun after the menopause, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, not long for you two.
You're either mental or you're shitting yourself.
Or both. Both, isn't it?
Another risk factor is sort of damage down below. Sort of nerve damage.
Interesting.
Yes.
I understand what you're saying there.
So people... So people who have long-standing diabetes or multiple sclerosis, or conditions that can cause nerve damage, but you can
like
have
anal
a little,
sex.
You could, yes, if you partake of that on a regular basis, Mr. Kiff, you may have that issue.
Depends what side of the anal sex you're on, doesn't it? I suppose.
Either way, it affects you one way or the other.
Yeah.
Yes, but there are
not out
little...
of the woods yet, Kimmy. Or out of the closet, I should say.
You talk about dementia is one another risk factor. Obviously, fecal incontinence at the late stage of life, Alzheimer's disease, and dementia.
Mm-hmm. Well, I suppose because if you get up, you feel the movement, don't you? You get up, you go upstairs.
You can't remember why you went
there. Yeah, you come back down.
Well,
you
think you're sitting on the toilet, but you're not really. I remember when I used to go to the toilet.
God.
So emotional distress and things like this could be.
Which, to be fair to Amber, she might very well have been on there.
Emotional.
That's probably the only time I will defend Amber Heard.
Wow.
But as she's such a young age, there is treatment for her.
Yep, there's hope for her yet.
There are some surgical treatments, did you know?
Okay.
I think you should start with the mental ones, to be honest with you there.
Okay, there's some psychological treatment you can go through.
But what sort of surgery would they do then?
Well, I'll tell you what. I'll tell you about the continence.
They just tighten the butthole.
Make it harder. She can't do it while she's laughing.
So if you may be right there, Miss Fork, because there's an operation to repair damaged muscles in your anus,
okay,
which cause a sphincteroplasty.
Okay.
Yeah.
A sphincteroplasty.
Sorry,
I misheard.
Or
you can put pasty up there and it'll stop it as well.
Put it in a pasty.
Sorry, yeah. They do that in the southwest.
That's like moon shaped.
Or
and clenched together like it is.
You can place a small electronic device under your skin to help the muscles and nerves in your anus work better. This is called sacral nerve stimulation.
What part of your skin are you putting this electronic?
Yeah, down there. Sacral nerve.
Ooh. That sounds like a night out for some people.
Yeah.
You've been following me. No. Injecting a substance such as silicone into the muscles in your anus to help them make them stronger. And injecting bulking agents.
Jesus.
A bit like they do with the lips.
Yeah. Yes. Basically, yeah, plastic surgery.
Yummy.
A bum lift.
Yeah.
Wow.
Although you're not going to kiss
we must remember that Amber wasn't suffering with any of these conditions. He just thought it would be a laugh to take a crap in his bed. Oh, come on.
Yeah.
So those are the scientific or the medical ways of looking at
well,
it. But
Amber,
it could be that she was just
help.
High on drugs and, you know, just having a...
Or she's following that age-old adage, why have a nap when you can have a crap?
Oh, dear.
Thank you for that insight, Nobby.
Thank you. Yeah. Okay. I seem to be coming on to do all these funny things you're asking me to do. And Siobhan thinks I have a propensity for this activity. I heard your shee-wee little escapade.
You'll be delighted to know, Dr. Tench, that I purchased myself a shee-wee.
Oh.
I haven't tried it yet, though.
You have to
test it out in
clear.
The shower, as Simone said,
yeah.
And I haven't yet brought it upstairs.
You know, it's the ordinary shower; it's none of this nonsense. <the shower>.
Wow!
Trump paid for that, didn't he?
In more ways than one.
Maybe we'll find out that Johnny Depp and Amber have been playing around with a shiwi as well later on.
I mean, do they stop for the weekend? There are two more Americans that are in England. Oh, no, she's not. She's British, isn't she?
Who, Amber?
No, she's American.
Yeah,
she's
they're both American.
So they couldn't have done this in America.
Yeah, well, yeah. I suppose the funny thing is that this is him suing the Sun. And yet, everything that's coming out is related to essentially their relationship and their nasty divorce. I mean,
the Sun don't need to do a double scoop on them. They've got it coming out in their libel case.
I mean, you know, the money that they're making all the money now with the papers.
Yeah,
to pay off
exactly.
The libel if they lose.
What I liked today, though, in today's paper was that they had photographed Amber going into the court yesterday and she was waving to the crowd.
She was.
Smiling and waving, and you just think, this is not good publicity. You shouldn't be happy about this.
They've always said there's no such thing as bad publicity.
I suppose. I think, Amber definitely...
Irrespective. I'd like to see the angle she goes on when they ask more about... her fecal fun.
Yeah, that's the thing. She's not been interviewed yet. It's only been Johnny.
How long is it scheduled for?
It's supposed to be 3 weeks, apparently.
Brilliant.
Yep.
Two more weeks of this.
Yep.
Do you think you can go to the public gallery and actually listen in?
Do you know what? I have no idea.
I think in some of the courts, they... with a social distancing thing, they did close the public galleries, but... I know someone who's just about to do jury service, so we'll find out.
Well, they'll be selling tickets for this one, won't they?
Yeah,
they probably would.
Come and swap your Disneyland tickets for this.
This could be... Do you think that would be an attraction at Disneyland?
Johnny Bed's...
I'll see the Pirates of the Caribbean and...
Jack Sparrow's car crash of a marriage. Oh, Lord. I mean, yeah, shit in the bed was just one of many things that has come out.
But there were some other...
Yes, there are some text messages were released today sent between Johnny Depp and actor Paul Bettany.
Unfortunately, I don't know who Paul Bettany is.
He was in the Marvel films.
Again, you're not getting any warmer with me on this one.
He was in A Knight's Tale.
Oh, right.
No.
So which character was he in the Marvel films?
He was the character... whose name? Jarvis was his name.
Oh, right, okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But A Knight's Tale, you must have seen that.
Have you not seen that?
No. Oh, I think I have. It's right. Got...
Maybe, yeah.
It's got Geoffrey Chaucer,
is that... No, it's not Celia Imrie and Trevor Heath Howard.
Yeah.
No, I mean, they have a fella playing Jeffrey
Shawson. Oh, that's him. That's him. That's Paul Bettany.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Right.
I thought you were talking about the original Chaucer.
The original Chaucer.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He wasn't there.
The Canterbury Tales.
Yeah, no, I'm pretty sure Paul Bettany plays him.
Right.
Yeah, so there was text messages between the two of them talking. Well, Johnny was saying that he would like to burn Amber because she's a witch. And Paul Bettany suggested that they went for the English option, which would be to throw her in water and see if she drowns.
Yeah, the old ducking.
Yeah. And either way, Johnny decided he would like to do both and then also play with her corpse afterwards. Ooh, just play, to make sure.
Like a chess game.
And this was because. So this was this trial was because he was a wife beater.
Yeah. So he won't beat her while she's alive, but once she's dead, he'll do anything.
It would appear it's a necrophilia.
Yeah, he's into that. Yeah,
but he's not into bed shitting.
No,
but he's into necrophilia.
Nor is he a wife beater.
Wow.
Oh Lord. Yes.
It's unique. They are fantastic, aren't they?
Their drug use has really come out in this trial as well.
I never believed they took any.
Well, Johnny Depp has admitted it several times.
He hasn't, does he?
Yeah. Johnny Depp's no. Lord,
which voice did he do when he was admitting it? Was it Jack Sparrow? Because I like that voice.
Yeah, that's very true, actually. I wonder. And who are you today, Mr. Depp?
Edward Scissorhands.
Willy Wonka.
Willy Wonka.
He was in another one, wasn't he? Another film where it had Christopher Walken in as...
That was...
on the horse.
Yes, that was Sleepy Hollow.
Sleepy Hollow. You're a real film buff on it, aren't you?
I actually would have called myself a Johnny Depp fan up until...
Oh, no!
No. He's you know, he's made good films.
He has.
Not good life choices, but good films.
There is an age difference between them of over 20 years, isn't there?
Yeah, you're familiar with that, aren't you?
So I would imagine.
This is a warning for you.
If I ever get to that age. But I do
imagine... Yeah, if you ever have to sue anyone for libel.
He'll be regretting his choices.
Yes, I think he's already doing that, to be perfectly honest. But, I think when he divorced her, he was already regretting his choices.
Has he got a new partner?
Has he got a new partner? I don't know, actually.
Have a new partner. Yeah. I saw they were... I mean, I didn't realise Amber Heard was so young where she had to be walked to the court by what would appear to be a mother and a nanny.
I wouldn't even mind, but yeah, there was a picture of them in the paper the other day. It was herself, her sister and her lawyer. And they all had masks on, but they were all holding hands. Her girlfriend was walking behind.
Her girlfriend rather than her partner.
Right.
What do you mean rather than her partner?
Well, when you say a girlfriend...
Oh, I mean like her girlfriend.
Like her partner girlfriend.
Yeah, like her partner girlfriend. Not just one of the girls who came along.
Johnny Depp and I have that in common.
You have a lot of things in common, we know this week.
Yeah,
we're not quite sure who is taking life tips from whom.
He was in a rock band, wasn't he?
Yes, he was. Another little notch that you can add. but yes, we'll see how this case develops over the next couple of weeks. Looking forward to it.
I am looking forward to the rest of it. I can't wait till she's on the stand, though.
Yes, it'll be interesting. Apparently, they're going to also interview Winona Ryder and his ex, Vanessa Paradis, as well.
I used to like Vanessa Paradis.
Yeah, Joe Le Taxi.
Joe Le Taxi.
Yeah, but she was also quite young as well, wasn't she? Quite. When you married her, she was six or something.
She was six, was she?
but she was very young.
They weren't married.
They had children.
No. They had children, but they weren't married.
Wow. You don't have to be married to have children,
Kim. We're going to move on from there quickly.
I feel another John song is coming on.
Quite an apt song, really, I think, as well, the next one. But you were saying there that the... No, hold on, I forgot. I've missed my line there.
Missed his line.
Oh dear.
As if we're that organised.
Yeah.
line.
You rehearse this, don't you? Yeah.
I went to a theatre once, and the fella stood there, and he was quite a well-known actor. And then he would talk and suddenly go, line, and he did this about four times. And I wonder whether it was anything to do with his coke habit.
Very true.
Go, boom, boom.
So still, shh, shh, you're all alone, shh, shh, and so peaceful until you fall in love, simple, the sky up above, simple, is caving in.
Wow, wow!
You never been so nuts about a guy, you wanna love, you wanna cry, you cross your heart and hope to die till it's over, and then shh, shh, it's nice and quiet, shh, shh, but soon again shh, shh, starts another big riot. You blow a fuse, simple, the devil cuts loose, simple, so what's the use?
Wow!
Of falling in love. It's oh so quiet.
We're back in the room.
Right.
Another interesting choice of song there, Kiffy.
Well, I thought it paid homage to I've forgotten their names, Johnny and Amber.
Johnny and Amber.
When they were together, people referred to them as Jamba.
Jamber. Oh, I like that.
Jomba.
Like Jomber. Yeah, maybe. Jomba. Yeah. I like that.
Yeah, I'm here all day.
Better than Abby, anyway.
Ambon.
Yeah.
Jambon.
Yeah.
Jambon.
Yeah. Speaking of power couples, Ghislaine Maxwell was arrested this week. Her name was actually, we had a bit of a dilemma with her name, didn't we?
I just called her Maxwell because I thought she was actually the daughter.
I'll refer to her as Maxwell from now on.
Is she the daughter of Robert Maxwell? Is she anything to do with the Maxwells?
Yes, she is, isn't she?
Is she the daughter or the daughter of the son?
You mean the granddaughter? Yeah, she's the daughter.
Is she?
Yep.
Because she's not really a spring chicken, given that Maxwell committed suicide in the 80s, didn't he? And they didn't find him for weeks. Where he'd just washed up on the shore, they thought it was whale.
Oh, Jesus. Wow.
Given his size. Obviously, that was a wasted joke anyway. But I thought, I didn't think she'd be young enough to be in the Epstein.
Well, she...
Andrew. She's more of a friend of Prince Andrew.
Yeah, exactly. She
I know she's a procurer.
Yes, exactly.
She allegedly,
the
sorry.
The fixer, apparently. Yeah, the fixer.
All I keep thinking of is the film The Sting. Every time you said the fixer, I've got that music.
Oh, right. Scott
Joplin. The entertainer going around in my head.
Well, she was arrested in New Hampshire this week at her million dollar mansion. They needed something ridiculous like... So they had a convoy of 15 vehicles. They had two helicopters. They had some other weirdness going on. And it's like, it's just for one person. The FBI
was
there.
Who's actually quite old and is not really going to do a run.
Yeah, she's a 58-year-old woman in her house.
I don't slippers. Know. Yeah. Slippers and pipe.
I don't she's know why, knitting, why you know, 24 cars and helicopters were necessary.
Yeah, Cliff Richard said something about that as well, didn't he?
Oh, did he?
Good old Cliff.
Well, in light of her arrest, Virginia Goof Roberts, who we all know famously as the woman in the picture with Andrew.
Oh,
the
yes.
The infamous photoshopped picture, according to Andrew.
He may have been upstairs, he may have been at the place.
Yeah, yeah, he certainly
recall.
didn't have his hand around her anyway, even though that's what it looks like in the photo.
Photoshop that was.
She was on Australian TV this week and she, well, I mean, unsurprisingly, she kind of has it in for Andrew. And she basically said, you know, now that Ghislaine's been arrested, this is Andrew's time. You know, he's going to get it soon.
Well, I reckon he'd already had it, though.
It's all
going to
come out. Yeah. He's going to be held accountable, as it were.
As a royal, though, that's highly unlikely, isn't it? Given that America doesn't... There's no way, and he's not going to travel back and forth anymore.
No, I don't think so.
And there won't be an international arrest warrant for one of...
No,
one of the
and
monarchs.
All the royals are expected to fly economy these days. So,
oh, right.
Of course.
You know, because Harry and Meghan like the environment and all that, so...
I was reading on...
They're no longer royal.
Can they be arrested now?
I'll come back to that one. Sorry, that was my senior moment.
Yeah. But Dr. Tench, you gave us something really nice today.
Yes, well, the thing is, I know that Mr. Kiff over there is quite a history buff, as he calls himself. or he reads history in the buff. That's what he told me. So, how do you remember all these kings and queens of England, you know? How can you do it?
How do you do it, Kivvy?
Well, I am very, very lucky because I was talking with Dr. Tench about doing something else and I wanted his help.
Okay.
And he asked me the same question then.
Yep.
I said to him, look, it's easy. Once you get the rhythm,
right,
it'll just come to you.
Are you talking about history now?
Yeah.
So if I was to go to you...
Willy, Harry, Stee.
Harry, Dick, John, Harry, 3.
1, 2, 3, Ned's Richard, 2.
Harry, 4, 5, 6, then who?
Edward's, 4, 5, Dick the Bad.
Harry's, 2, Ned's, 6, the Lad. Jesus, I'm out of time in there, hold on.
Mary, Bessie, James, you can.
Then Charlie, James again.
Will and Mary, Anna, Gloria.
George's, 4, Will, 4, Victoria.
Edward 7 next, and then
came George V in 1910.
Ned the Eighth soon abdicated.
Then George the Sixth was coronated.
After which, Elizabeth.
And that's all, folks, until her death.
Hey! Do you see how it just comes to you?
Yeah. I like it. I'm going to try and learn that one.
Yeah. Off my heart.
I think there's
Well,
I think you'll enjoy. I mean, hopefully we'll be able to get some history podcasts out there about great events in history. And once we stitch all these monarchs together, it'll all fall into place in our 28-hour marathon podcast.
Oh, God.
With sound effects.
That sounds amazing. Very excited about that.
I bet you can't wait.
Oh, Lord.
What else has been going on in the news?
What else? We have J.K. Rowling has been accused of... She's an enemy of progress, apparently.
An enemy of progress?
She's an enemy of progress. Yep. She has been dubbed dangerous to the LGBT community.
Ooh, dangerous?
Yes.
Whoa. I mean, that's one heavy slant, isn't it?
It is, really, yeah. So... JK, she's becoming quite renowned for either sharing controversial tweets or writing her own controversial tweets or liking controversial tweets.
Or even writing controversial books like that Harry Potter nonsense.
Yeah.
Witchery.
That wasn't very Christian of her.
Let's burn her.
So in this case, she has liked a comment. Basically saying that hormone prescriptions are the new antidepressants. She feels that they should be a last resort and not the first option. So, she then had to come out and defend herself after
she came out.
She came out. The LGBT community were not fond of her like. And as a result, she came out defending her stance, basically saying that she believes that doctors today are shunting young people towards hormones and surgery, when in actual fact, maybe what they actually need is just some mental care.
Can I just ask you there? I'm curious. When you say someone from the LGBTQ
community
didn't like what she... I mean, is there somebody monitoring what she likes?
I reckon there's lots of people monitoring what J.K. Rowling is up to these days.
She's on the
radar. Who's she going to target next?
Keep watching it. Don't let her go there. I'm going to go for a coffee.
To be fair, her last comments regarding people who menstruate, i.e. women...
I think she was being flippant.
That was a very anti-trans comment of her there.
I don't know about anti-trans.
Well,
I think
no,
it
but
was,
I feel like the trans community have their backs up. She's on their watch list.
Yeah, she wasn't really thinking.
She kind of dug herself in this time because she went on to say, Manny, myself included, believe we are watching a new kind of conversion therapy for young gay people.
She's not doing well.
Yeah,
with
that's
this
not
one.
A very good thing to say. So naturally, in this case, the LGBTQ plus community have basically had a whale of a time with this one.
Ooh.
And as a result, they have labelled her dangerous, an enemy to progress, and just insane in general.
Well, have you ever read Harry Potter,
no.
Nobby?
I'm not a Potter fan, Mr. Kiff, but I think J.K. Rowling is going to change. She's going to transition in the end, but she's causing a bit of stir there, I think. But
we had forgotten who she was for quite a while, and I hadn't heard anything from her.
Funnily enough, we had, yeah.
Mm. And suddenly this
has she got a new book coming out?
Yeah, maybe. Yes. Maybe around Christmas time we might hear something. I'm not sure. Well, I mean, I was just about to say I'm not sure it's good publicity, but then as you said,
any publicity is good publicity.
That's right. Yeah. There's no such thing as bad publicity. Getting a name up there, that'd be quite interesting. I was saying I was watching Ricky Gervais earlier do the 2020. I can't remember what are those things.
Oh, the Golden Globes. The Golden Globes.
Golden Globes.
Yeah.
And he was fantastic. I mean, he really took a strip off the star.
Yeah, he really pushes it close to the mark, doesn't
he? He does.
I think it goes beyond the mark. You can see a lot of them were clenching their buttocks a bit like Amber Reed should have done.
Yeah, she should have.
Her moment of mirth. But, yeah, and they shined onto some of the actors. There were some British ones in there. and Jane were cold and cringy.
Uncomfortable.
It's cringeworthy.
But he didn't have a go at De Niro.
Oh, you he can't. Didn't. You can't really do that, can you?
Talking to me.
Sorry. But De Niro found a lot of the stuff funny.
Oh, yeah.
Well, he's an old man, isn't he?
He is.
He's none of it's against him.
Yeah,
that's true.
Yeah, he's a bit of a fucker, though, isn't he?
Oh, very good.
Speaking of, I'm afraid I have to leave now, but I'll just leave you with this thought. What did this dad joke, really? did J-Berg send this to you? What did the cheese say in the mirror?
I don't know.
Halloumi.
If I had a tumbleweed found now.
Yeah, that's what we need.
And in that, with that bombshell, I shall see. I'll see you, next month.
See you next month. Thank you, Nobby.
You take care out that door there and make sure the red light's on.
Eat out to help out, Nobby.
Spend your tenner wisely.
Yeah.
Burger King or... I think some of them are closing down now.
That's right, yeah. Burger King is...
Do the whole family.
But I think that the burger... Also, the fast food industry, thankfully, is dying.
Do you think it's dying?
I hope it's dying.
I think it's more hope rather than
waste of
fact.
Energy cooking this stuff that's already been cooked 20 times and then injecting it with water and making people believe it's really moist and succulent.
Yeah.
KFC have done that to me so many drunken nights. I've lost count.
Sometimes you just need a bit of dirty food.
Food porn is... No, I mean, I'm a reformed.
You prefer original porn. Speaking of porn, and actually going back to what we were talking about earlier. So obviously, as I was saying earlier, outdoor performances are now allowed. However, one thing that will not be allowed, unfortunately, is the UK Swingers Sex Festival. And despite the fact that it was going to be held outside, basically they've had to cancel it because of social distancing.
They hold this outside.
Well, yeah. It's like a festival, so they've got tents and, you know, they go camping.
They're swingers.
You know.
I mean, come on, they're not going to worry about clothes, are they?
Leather outfits
and the like, but yeah.
It would have been in Worcestershire, apparently. The event runs between a Thursday and a Sunday.
Because
Yes. Devastated fans have voiced their upset. Yes, apparently. And
they've written on the website.
Yeah, on the Facebook page. Yeah. Oh, Lord.
I mean, why don't they just... you can be in each other's bubble, so a couple of them could meet up and carry on doing whatever it is they do.
Yes. I mean, I don't know if when you go to this sex festival, do you go there with friends or do you go there with the idea of wanting to meet strangers? Tickets.
A bit like Glastonbury. Turn up with a picnic basket.
Hold on, Kit, shouldn't you know about this?
Do
you want to invite someone to such an event?
I said, no, it wasn't that at all. It was a bit of a misread thing.
I see.
And I jokingly said to one person, shall you, do you fancy coming to this with me?
Yeah.
And I wouldn't, I mean, it was not something I would go to in King's Cross. However.
Did you think it was a drive-in cinema?
No. It's very clear, I mean, what they're, it's very much for voyeurs. And then they said, you know, you can all sorts of other shenanigans that went on. But I thought it would be funny.
Right.
She appeared initially to have a sense of humour,
right,
which rapidly evaporated as I got through the sentence.
I see.
And if I recall, was sobbing her heart out to you, Glorious. An hour later.
Well, if you ever do change your mind, Kiffy,
well, we're not going to have any work experience people here again, are we? So.
The festival is called the Aurora Lifestyle Festival.
Aurora,
yeah.
Now, I know there's a Norwegian singer called Aurora. She's not going to be happy at that, is
That's
she?
That's right, there is, yes.
Yeah. I might write to her. So I'm a fan of hers and write to her and say, Aurora, was it your festival?
Yeah, it's very true, actually, yeah. What I also like about this article is that all the photos are aerial. Aerial view photos and like drone
zoomed
photos.
Out as
yeah,
much as
yeah. There's no close ups. Looks like a.
They probably lost cult. 14 or 15 drones already yeah, when they've been
yeah,
shot down.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
And that was why they were quickly reloading. They get another one up now, quickly.
Yeah, quickly. In other news, Richard Madeley has had to apologise for misjudging domestic violence advice.
God
now,
almighty.
It is curious how one can misjudge
he's
that
a
sort
cretin.
Of advice.
He's an absolute cretin because he is original smarm, isn't he?
He's like very smarmy, I have to
Bob
say.
Bob Monkhouse covered in grease.
Yeah, he's proper smarm. He was giving... he was basically... what's the word? He was being an agony aunt, if you like.
Yeah, right, of course. Known for that.
In his newspaper column. He writes for the Daily Telegraph. And someone...
Has the Telegraph fallen that far?
Someone had written in talking about their neighbours and how there had been shouting and she'd heard banging and there was all sorts of stuff going on and she was quite worried that...
Johnny and Amber, as they now know.
Yes, exactly. She was quite worried that Johnny and Amber were getting up to dangerous... domestic violence acts. And basically, in response to this poor woman's, or well, poor writer's fears, Richard said that if they were going to kill each other, they'd have done it by now.
Oh, he's fantastic, isn't he?
Yes, yes.
And that was the full advice he gave them.
I mean, I don't know if there was more to it than that, but that was the
did he
the
have
essence.
An, oh, come on?
Yeah, probably, yeah.
One of those sentences in there. What a cretin. But yeah. He's married to that woman.
He's married to Judy.
He's been married to her for a long, long time, hasn't he?
Yes, yes.
They both cling on to each other like a pair of drowning...
I do like it whenever they present Good Morning together. Yeah, it's Good Morning, isn't it? Yeah.
Is it?
She always looks like she can't stand him. Yeah. She's always like rolling her eyes, or she's like huffing, or she's like...
And he's desperately going on, come on, like me, I'm funny.
Yeah,
I'm funny.
He's trying to be cool, that's what the problem is.
I do recall
but
him once.
He's too old to be cool these days.
But I think he was too old to be cool then. And that was when he was in his 30s. But it's his hairstyle that doesn't help.
Yes, he's gone blonde now. Yeah,
he's got some quite
lovely blonde locks at the moment.
Who would go blonde? Why don't he just retain his own hair colour?
I wonder.
Oh, yeah. We often ask ourselves about that, don't we?
But apparently it does make you look younger. I wouldn't know.
Yeah.
But yeah, he once met the character Ali G.
Right, okay.
And he wanted to dress up, and he came dressed up as Ali G.
Okay.
And he thought it would be funny. And he looked like a knob.
Yeah.
Dare I say it. But here's another lovey gone by the wayside.
Yeah.
Along with Michael Barrymore. Richard
yeah.
Madeley.
Yep, Richard Madeley. Mm-hmm.
I love that advice. They would have killed each other by now. I wonder if his wife rolled her eyes at that before hitting him.
No doubt. Yeah, if there was any domestic violence going on, it's Judy. You idiot.
We're never going to get back on TV now.
Yeah, they'll never have us on Good Morning now. Never again. In other news, it is believed that the Norman Conquest brought pork to Britain.
Really?
Yeah.
The Norman Conquest?
Yeah, apparently. Between the 10th and the 13th century.
Sorry, I had to get that one out. I was surprised because the Danes, given the Danes lived here, and the Germans, or the Saxons rather, lived here before then.
Yeah. I've just realised I might have read this article wrong. What the Norman Conquest did was bring better farming, which meant the pigs ate better, which meant the pork
better quality,
tasted better.
Mind you, I think pork is quite stringy anyway, but yeah, I agree.
On that
with
note,
you.
It's time to end the show.
How are we doing for time, Glorious?
You've only got a little bit left, actually. 10 seconds.
Oh,
right,
see you later,
Zoe. Well. We're out of here. Get the door slamming as we leave.
Yeah. Bye.
We called it. Bye. Bye. Have a lovely weekend.